Hey, what's up guys, it's Kausu. We are back with another video, and guys, as per the title, in this video I will be showing you on how you can install a custom ROM on any Android smartphone that has came out since 2017. So this is a general video as to how you can install a custom recovery, as well as install get root access and install or flash a custom ROM onto your Android device. So in this video I'll be telling you four basic steps which I follow personally whenever I am flashing a recovery or flashing a custom ROM. So make sure you follow these four steps and watch the complete video till the end. Also guys, make sure you hit that red subscribe button down below and also turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. So without wasting any further time, let's roll the intro and let's get the video started. So firstly guys, make sure your phone supports a custom ROM, that it should have custom ROMs. So just firstly go on google.com and just type in the name of your phone. So right now I have the OnePlus 3T, and just after the phone name, just type for custom ROM here, as you can see. So you will get a couple of results. So here, as you can see, there is this site, XDA Developers is the trusted site which you should refer if you are into custom ROM and Android development. So each phone has its own forum here on XDA Developers website. You can just search on Google by putting your phone name and then putting custom ROM, and you will get a lot of results. So guys, if your phone supports custom ROM development, if it has custom ROMs available, then only it is worth proceeding further in the video, because if your phone doesn't have any custom ROM development, then there is no point in proceeding further. So make sure you check whether your phone supports custom ROM and Android development. In this step, we have to unlock the bootloader of our smartphone. So to unlock the bootloader of our smartphone is like internal storage which you have to unlock. But right now guys, the problem is that my bootloader of the OnePlus 3T is already unlocked. I will just quickly show you by restarting the smartphone. So while restarting, you will see this unlock status quickly. It just flashes for a couple of seconds. So right now it just vibrated. So as you can see, right, if you see this kind of a menu, that means your bootloader is already unlocked. So my bootloader is already unlocked. But then too guys, I will help you out. So if you have any other smartphone than the OnePlus 3T, then I have posted links in the description down below which you can check. There are a couple of video tutorials on famous smartphones. Couple of smartphones have provided tutorial, as well as the OnePlus 3T, on how you can unlock the bootloader of your smartphone and how you can install a custom ROM or custom recovery, that is a TWRP recovery on your smartphone. So I will just show you my TWRP recovery also. So right now guys, I have pressed the power button as well as the volume up button here. In that way you can get into the custom recovery of your smartphone. So I will just quickly scroll with the help of my volume key down to recovery mode and press the power button right here. So now it will boot into the recovery directly. We have to wait for about 5 seconds to the recovery to boot. So this is the OnePlus logo, and as you guys can see, this is the TWRP recovery, TeamWin recovery, which I have already installed on my smartphone because my bootloader is unlocked, as well as I have a custom recovery in place. So this is how the TWRP recovery looks, and there are a couple of options which is quite helpful to install custom ROM. So make sure you complete this second step by unlocking the bootloader and flashing a custom TWRP recovery. Then the next step, in step 3, what you have to do is that you have to backup your stock ROM. So it is quite a crucial and a important step which all of you have to seriously follow, because if you don't backup your stock ROM, you are in trouble. Because if anything happens, if your device gets bricked, if the custom ROM if you are trying to install that fails, then your backup is what is gonna save you from getting your device bricked or getting your device unusable. So make sure you always backup. So here in the custom TWRP recovery, if you click in this backup menu here, you get a lot of options. Just make sure you tick all of them. I at least tick all of them, because all of them are important, like boot partition, cache partition, data partition, recovery partition, system image, as well as EFS partition, and also select the storage. So right now I have only internal storage, so I've selected internal storage. Click on OK, give it the name of your choice. I just keep it the date so that I can remember which date I have backed up this ROM. Currently I will be backing up my paranoid Android ROM. Also in options, make sure you click on enable compression so that the size of the backup is less, otherwise it is huge size, file size of the backup. And yeah, that's about it. And just swipe here. So after doing that, it will take a couple of minutes to complete the backup. Like it takes about 5 to 6 minutes to complete the whole backup procedure. I will quickly show you by going here. Now whenever you want to restore your backup file, guys, you have to go in restore here, and right now it is not showing, but if you back it up, you will have the ROM file here, and you have to click on it and just simply flash it if something goes wrong during the whole ROM installation procedure. So that's why you have to back up your stock ROM or whichever ROM which is working perfectly fine on your smartphone. Fourth step is to download a custom ROM. Yes, the custom ROM which I told you in first step, the download the custom ROM of your choice. Make sure it is for your device only and not for some other device, otherwise it can create a lot of problems. So make sure you download the right custom ROM, and custom ROMs usually come in this zip file format, guys. So after that you have downloaded the custom ROM, guys, firstly you have to make sure you there are two options for flashing a custom ROM. First option is clean flashing and the second option is dirty flashing. I would not recommend you the second option, that is dirty flashing, because that can create a lot of problems in the ROM which you install. So always prefer the first option, that is clean flashing. So to clean flash, firstly guys, you have to wipe your whole phone. So make sure you back up all of your data, your photos, your videos, transfer it to an external drive or transfer it to your PC. That's the most preferable choice, I would say. Then so to wipe your phone, just go in wipe and go in advanced wipe here and select all of these options: Dalvik cache, then cache, data, internal storage, as well as system. So select all of these options and just swipe here to wipe. So it takes a couple of seconds to completely wipe your smartphone. So as you can see, it has completed right now. So after the wipe complete is successful, then what you have to do is just connect your smartphone with the USB cable to your PC directly. So just connect it, and the zip file which you have downloaded on your PC, you have to transfer it to your Android smartphone. So guys, once you have transferred the file directly from your ROM file from your PC to your Android smartphone, guys, then if you go into this install menu right here in the custom recovery, you will see the file. So I have downloaded this custom ROM which is called as the Evolution X, and it is a zip file. So transfer that file to your internal storage by connecting it to a PC while your Android smartphone is in recovery mode. So now that I have completed the wipe, my phone is completely empty, and now I can clean flash this ROM. So just click on this Evolution X ROM, and here you have to don't mess with any of these options. Just swipe this to confirm the flash. So as you can see, the title has come, Evolution X, and it takes a couple of seconds again to install this ROM. So let's just wait for it. So guys, right now as you can see, the ROM has completely installed on my smartphone. Also guys, another thing I would like to mention is that some ROMs come with default gapps. Gapps means Google apps, like Gmail, YouTube, Google Play Store, all those are gapp package comes. So in some ROMs, the developer mentions that gapp is already included in the ROM, or in some other ROMs you have to flash the gapp separately. So I have also provided a link to gapps. If you are interested, you can check that out too. But right now in my case, while making this video, this ROM comes by default installed with gapps. So I have not installed gapps separately. Also guys, if you want root access on your smartphone, you can head over to this description box below, and there is a file link given for Magisk. So Magisk is also Magisk manager is basically to gain root access to your smartphone. So that is also a small zip file that you get. Again, it is the same procedure. You have to transfer it to your smartphone from your PC, and then again flash the Magisk zip file on your smartphone. Like it is the same procedure like you have installed your custom ROM. So it's quite easy, just do it, and after rebooting you will have a root access as well as the new ROM installed. So I'll just quickly now reboot my smartphone so that I can see the new ROM that has been installed. So right now, as you guys can see, after you install a custom ROM, it might take a couple of minutes for your smartphone to boot. So be patient. So right now I have installed the Evolution X custom ROM for my OnePlus 3T here, and as you can see, the ROM has booted completely, and now it is asking for the setup procedure. So let's start with the setup procedure. So right now, as you guys can see, the ROM has booted. I have finished the initial setup here, and this is the Evolution X ROM which I have installed right now here. So here, as you guys can see, this is the Evolution X ROM that I have just installed in front of you with the help of TWRP recovery, and this has a GHAPS pre-installed, so I didn't need to flash GHAPS separately, as well as I have not flashed the Magix manager because I don't require root access on a daily basis. If you want, you can flash that also so that you can get a root access. That means your device is rooted also. So here, if you can see the info, it is currently running on Android version 10, as it is an Android 10 based ROM for the OnePlus 3T. That's pretty much it for this video, guys. I hope you guys like this video, and if you like it, please do hit the like button down below, and also do get subscribed to my channel, as well as turn the notifications on so that you don't miss any of my latest videos. So that's about it. This is your boy Kaustubh here from T2E signing off. You guys have a great day.